What is up, you beautiful people, and welcome back to the Upper 90 YouTube Soccer Channel. This weekend, we have Chelsea versus Manchester United, which means we need to talk about the injury report. So stick around as we dive deeper into this. For those that don't know who I am, my name is Mike, huge Chelsea fan, which is why each and every week we do the injury report.
I hate you!
Give you an update on the status of all the Chelsea players who are hurt, who may make the game, who may miss the game. And in today, like I said, we are going to go over those players. Now, today we only have four players missing out, which is kind of good, kind of bad, depending on how you look at it, because some of these injuries are obviously bigger than they should be, and some of these injuries may take a lot longer to take on and heal up. Now, that being said, our first injury that we need to go over is with Kai Havertz. Now, this guy's been playing a lot of games as of lately, so it's not too surprising. He ended up dealing with some type of thigh injury. It looks like it could be a hamstring injury, hard to say. He was subbed off in the last game, and it looks like right now he will be 25% ready for this upcoming weekend against Manchester United, and most likely will probably not even be on the bench because Romelu Lukaku and Timo Werner are back in the starting 11, so therefore I think Kai Havertz finally is going to get some rest, which he is well deserving because, again, he's been running the front line for so many games since those two players were out injured. Now, following that, we drop to the midfield where we have multiple players hurt there. We have N'Golo Kante as our first player, who also picked up an injury against Juventus. This one, it's hard to say exactly what exactly is going on with him right now, but it looks like he picked up a minor knock. Did come off pretty early in this match, and again, he most likely will be missing out in this upcoming weekend against Manchester United, and therefore I can see Ruben Loftus-Cheek starting with Jorginho in the midfield because Mateo Kovacic is also still hurt with his hamstring injury. So because of that, right now we are a little bit weaker, or I shouldn't say weaker, a little bit thinner in the midfield as of right now, because again, with those two players injured, that pretty much leaves us with Ross Barkley, Jorginho obviously, Ruben Loftus-Cheek, and Saul in the midfield. Yes, you could put Mason Mount there, but pretty much it's probably going to be Ruben and Jorginho starting this weekend, which I'm actually really looking forward to seeing what Ruben can do with a full 90 minutes, because this player is such a fun player to watch because he's able to dance on the ball, as we saw against Juventus with that amazing assist he had to Hudson-Odoi, but also he can body players and break down other teams and really just block out anything that's coming down the midfield. And with Jorginho next to him, I think this will be a very good pairing. And last but not least, our other injury, which again came in the Juventus game. We just picked up a lot of injuries in this match, and it's a shame because we had such a good game, winning 4-0 against Juventus at home at Stamford Bridge was such a great win. But again, it came with the price, and that being Ben Chilwell. It's hard to say exactly what is going on right now. It looks like it's going to be an ACL type injury. Not too sure if there is a full tear, a slight tear, or something else along those lines. They're being very cautious right now. But that being said, it looks like it's going to be at least 6 weeks, probably not till January. We're going to maybe see him play again. And even if that is the best case scenario, I think it's going to take some time for him to get back into where he was before. And therefore, it might not even be till February, if not maybe the end of the season. Who knows? And worst case scenario, he's obviously out for the rest of the season and won't be starting till next season, which hopefully that is not the case. But again, they're taking it day by day and seeing how well he's doing. And hopefully it's nothing as severe as a full tore or tear in the ACL. But again, it's really difficult to say right now. Luckily, we do have Marcus Alonso, who can step up there as Phil Kwaita can also slide in that position, since Trevor Chalobah has been playing so well in the defensive position. Obviously, Reece James is a tank, so again, he will be starting in the right wing. So again, looking forward to this weekend against Manchester United. Obviously, Thomas Tuchel will have to change up his tactics a little bit due to the fact we picked up a few different injuries all over the pitch. But overall, I see Chelsea doing fairly well against Manchester United. Looks like Michael Carrick will still be there managing the team, even though they have talks about bringing a different manager in. I think because of that, that gives Chelsea a bigger upper hand, even though Anthony Taylor is reffing this match. So again, that makes it all up in the air as well. But overall, I think Chelsea have a good chance in this match, and I actually see them winning 3-0 in this game. So that is all I have for you today. If you are new to this channel, make sure to hit the like button and subscribe down below. I greatly appreciate that. Helps get this channel to more and more fans of this club and sport, and again, just helps grow this YouTube channel. So again, I appreciate it, and thank you very much, and I will see you next time.